Thank you. And now the playing of our national anthem.
Number one,
Yeah, baby! Yeah! Now, batting number two, the shortstop, Steven Ramos.
There's Robinson with the pitch. That's going to miss inside. One and one the count. That's going to hit the outside corner for strike two. One ball, two strikes. And time called at the plate just as Robinson was about to make his pitch. Here comes the 1-2. And inside evens the count at 2-2. Here's the 2-2. And hits that strong to center field. Johnson and gets right underneath it and makes the second out. Holds the runner at second base. Brings up Ben Francis, the right fielder, number 21, right-handed hitter. Trinity Christian in royal blue helmets, jersey with white numbers and white pinstripe pants. Your Lobos are in their grays with their navy blue tops, white numbers and white letters. And hits that strong over short for a base hit. Mateer will cut that off and one run will score from second. And Trinity strikes first. One zero is our score. Trinity Christian with the lead. Two away and a runner at first. A.J. Golgurri. And outside corner for strike one. That's going to be short hopped and will get away from the catcher Markheim. And the runner will advance to second base on a pass ball. Here's the pitch, and outside, 1-1 the count. Correction, 2-1. And that's going to get the outside corner for strike two, evens the count at 2-2. Here's the 2-2, and hits that towards second. And he tries to dive at it and miss it. And a throw to home, and will not be in the right place. And another run will score, and the other runner will advance to second. Two to zero is our score, and Coach Harbin will come out and talk to his young freshman pitcher. Top of the first brought to you by Cottonwood Creek Marina and Billy Goat. Also want to mention D3 Solana Washone Washateria sponsoring foul balls here this top of the first order. Top of the first. As we mentioned, the wind is blowing. Currently here in Little Elm, here in the backyard, it is 67 degrees. It feels like 67, but the wind currently blowing northwest at 16 miles an hour. If you are in the shade, it is cold. The sun just now started to drop on the back here of my position here up in the stands. And it's starting to get a little warmth, but not enough for me to take my jacket off. William Lehman comes to the plate, number 17. He is the first baseman for the Trojans. And that's going to hit the outside corner for strike one. Runner at second base, 2-0 is our score. Trojans striking first here in the top of the first order. Here's the pitch from Robinson. That's going to be high and outside, inside, but outside the back shoulder of the batter. Good job by Paxton Markheim getting to that ball. 1-1 the count. Here's the 1-1, and that's going to miss low, 2-1. Hit strong between right and center field. That'll drop for a single, and the run will score from second, and their lead will increase to 3-0. Reagan Pierce, number 11, the designated hitter, comes up. As looks like James Holiday will head to the bullpen and start warming up. And hit strong again. This one out to left field. But this time a tier gets underneath and will end the inning. Four hits, three runs, no errors. As the Lobos will come into the bottom of the first to start their batting and try to come back on a 3-0 lead by the Trojans. Keep it here. We'll be right back. TSRN sports coverage of Little Elm Lobos baseball and also on Little Elm TV.
Take back control of your time. with BillyGo. When you use the BillyGo app, you choose the time that works best for you. As that time approaches, you can track your plumber on a real-time map to see exactly when he will arrive. No more sitting around at your house for hours. BillyGo is locally owned and operated and only hires the best plumbers. Download the BillyGo app today and set your schedule free. BillyGo. It's about time.
Rainer Chavez, Kendall Johnson, John Mateer, your first three batters here for the Lobos as they will face number 12, Will Martin, left-handed pitcher. Trinity Christian Trojans lead 3-0. Rainer Chavez comes in batting 300, 69 at bats, 21 hits, two home runs. He's got nine RBIs, 13 runs scored. Walked five times, struck out four times. And he'll foul tip this one off. 0-1 the count. Hits this one strong over second base, and that will drop for a base hit. So a leadoff single for Freiner Chavez. There comes the left-hander, Kendall Johnson. Johnson batting 140 on the season so far, 56 at-bats. He's got eight hits. He's also got 21 strikeouts. That's going to be high, ball one. He'll look to bunt. That'll be ball two. 2-0 to count to Johnson. Chavez, very dangerous as a base runner. And that's going to be popped up. And a bad throw to first as they'll get Kendall. And that's going to go all the way to the corner. Chavez, ground second. He'll come to third. And it looks like that's where they're going to hold him at. John Mateer will come to the plate, one away. That's going to hit the outside corner for strike one. Here's the 0-1 to Mateer. And a high and outside, 1-1 the count.
Guys, something that he tells to friends, and they tell to friends, and they tell their friends, and so on, and so on, and so on.
Here comes the 1-1 to Mateer. High, 2-1 the count. Chavez at third base, one away. Lobos down 3-0. Luis Cruz on deck. Swing and a miss, strike two. It's going to even the count at 2-2. Fouls this one off at the back of the net. Foul ball brought to you by Cammie Winover from Farmers Insurance. Also want to thank Ebby Holiday Realtors and LD Automotive. Thank you for being sponsors of Lobos Baseball. Keeps the count at 2-2. Hit high in between second base, and he'll get underneath it. Makes the out. Chavez is going to come here to home. And he will slide in for the score, makes it 3-1. Luis Cruz, the left-hander, comes up. Cruz batting 350, 66 at bats. He's got 23 hits. Only 5 strikeouts. That's going to be low. Ball one. Two away, nobody on. 3-1 is our score. And hit strong out to left field. That is back. That is deep. That is off the wall. And Cruz is going to pull up. And Cruz is hurt. That could have been an easy stand-up double, but he has been suffering with a hamstring injury. But he's been trying to gut it out and run it out, and that is what he's grabbing, is that hamstring. Coach Harbin comes out to talk to him. You also got Coach Holcomb out there on first base, and he's talking to him. We'll give some time to check things out. We'll be right back here on TSRN Sports and Little Elm TV. Keep it here as we check on Luis Cruz. Well, the good news is Cruz is up and walking to the dugout. Bad news is that might be all for him in the game here. We'll see what happens. as they're going to bring in Josh Montgomery to pinch run. So a runner at first base, two away here for the Lobos. They're down 3-1. And Brandon Dickinson. Dickinson batting 230 on the season. Outside, ball one. That's going to get in there for strike. One and one the count. And hit towards first. An easy play there for the first baseman. And that'll be out of the inning. As we head to the top of the second, Lobos get on the board. They're down 3-1. Keep it here. We'll be right back here on TSRN Sports and Little Elm TV.
Clear
blue skies, comfortable temperature if you're in the sun. If you're in the shade, it's a little chilly. And the Lobos will stick with their young pitcher, Roman Robinson, as he comes out on the hill. Up to bat here for the Trojans, Joshua Liu, Charles Frankie, and then back to Ryan O'Shea at the top of the order. Here we go. And that's going to be in there for strike one. 0-1 the count to Lou. Here in the top of the second. Fouls this one off. That foul brought to you by 717 Barber Studio. Also want to thank McKee Law Firm and Crossridge Church for being sponsors of the Little Elm Lobos. And that's going to be hit hard to short. Chavez grabs it easily, makes the throw to first, and that's in there for the first out. One away. That's going to ring out number 14. Charles Frankie, the second baseman.
Now by number 14, the second baseman, Charlie
Robinson in the windup. Here's the pitch. That's going to just miss outside. 1-0 the count. Oh, That fouls that one off inside, 1-1. That's going to be hit strong back to short. Chavez once again with the throw first. Two away.
Now batting number one.
That's going to bring up the top of the order, Ryan O'Shea, who flied out to center field. Or correction, I believe it was left field. On his first at bat. That's going to miss. Ball one. Two away, nobody on here at the top of the second. Here's the pitch. High, 2-0. That's going to be high, 3-0. Here comes the 3-0 pitch. That's going to miss on the inside for our first walk of the game. That's going to put a runner at first with two outs. Steven Ramos, who doubled and scored. Quick throw to first. In there, safe. Outside, 1-0. Swing and a miss, that's tipped. One ball, one strike. Is the count to Steven Ramos. Runner at first base. Two away. 3-1 is our score. And going for second, there's the throw. And it's going to be high, but backed up by Braden Howard, and he'll get the stolen base. Here's the 2-1, and again, fouled off. That's going to be in play. Quick throw to first, and they'll get the out to end the inning. So they'll strand one on base. Keep it here. Be right back as we head to the bottom of the second. Lobos coming up. They're down 3-1. Keep it here.
Deca Store, the best place to get the best snacks outside of lunch.
The Deca Store?
That's right, the Deca Store!
We have all the snacks you can get.
You heard right, all the snacks you can get.
We have drinks,
chips,
even Rice Krispie Treats.
You name it, you want it, we have it.
You have it?
We have it!
You also have fair price for anything you want to buy. That's right, fair prices!
Wow, now I think I'll always go to the Deca store.
Come visit the Deca store today!
Paxton Markheim, Irvin Leonard, and Roman Robinson are your batters up here for the Lobos. Paxton Markheim's got two at-bats. He's got no average right now. One strikeout recorded. That's going to miss inside, ball one. Young freshman prospect here for the varsity squad. Getting his shot in the varsity game here today. And hits this one strong. It is going to be deep, but it's going to be caught as the left fielder will get underneath it. One away. But good contact on the bat by Markheim.
And number 24, the first baseman, Irvin Leonard.
Leonard batting 259 at bats. He's got 12 hits, one home run, six RBIs, five runs scored. He's got eight walks, and he takes the first pitch strike. He's got 22 strikeouts. And hits this towards short. He'll collect it, makes the throw to first, two away. The pitcher, Roman Robinson. Robinson has no batting average. Actually showing a batting average of 100. That's going to be high, ball one. And he's going to get hit in the back by the pitch, and he'll take the walk. Dylan Terry will come to the plate. Dylan batting 100, 29 at bats. He's got three hits, two RBIs, four runs, one walk, five strikeouts. Dylan Terry, also a freshman. That's going to be high and outside, ball one. Quick throw to first. He's in there safe. And there he goes. Markheim for the steal. And they're going to get him. Three away. We head to the top of the third. Still 3-1. Trojans with the lead. Keep it here. We'll be right back. Thank you. Ian Collier, Ben Francis, A.J. Goliguri are your batters up here for the Trinity Christian Trojans. They lead 3-1 as we get started here in the top of the third. Want to mention American Lighting and Signalization, 3G Drywall and Hula Hut. Thank you for being sponsors of Lobos Baseball. Also Cottonwood Creek Marina and Billy Go. Sponsors of Lobos Baseball. Inside pitch. 1-0 the count. Here's the 1-0, and hit strong. Right center, that's going to get to the wall. And it'll be a stand-up double for Ian Collier. Ben Francis, the right fielder, singled. I believe he got the third on a pass ball and scored. Now he's got a runner at second with no outs. Swing and a miss, strike one. And he'll hit this one on the inside. Strong foul down the third baseline. That foul brought to you by Alex Dawson Photography. Thank you for being a sponsor of Lobos Baseball. 0-2 the count. No outs. Runner at second base. 3-1 is our score. Robinson with the windup of the pitch. And again, a quick chop swing, fouled off. Count remains 0-2. Outside, 1-2. Hit strong is short, out of the reach of Chavez. Mateer with the recovery, they'll hold the runner at third. We'll have runners at the corners, first and third, no outs. Here comes Coach Mark Smith, and it looks like he's going to go to the bullpen. He'll come out to talk to the young freshman. James Holiday in the bullpen throwing right now. Let's see if he'll go to that. So we had a scheduled game for Monday. Against Rockwall. We're going to be at Rockwall, but that game has changed. That has now been moved to Tuesday. So it's 7:30 p.m. start for the game at Rockwall right here on TSRN Sports. Will be Tuesday, not Monday. And that's going to be all for Roman Robinson. So two innings pitch for Robinson. Six hits, three runs. And he'll take the one error. does have one walk and no strikeouts. As James Holiday comes in relief. Like, there's some other changes going on because Roman will remain on the field. He went in and changed, got the sunglasses on, changed gloves. And look, from what I can tell, looks like he will take over at second base, which means I believe Dylan Howard will come out of the game. So Roman Robinson will remain in the game and take over at second base. Roman will actually move to third base, which puts Dylan Terry at second. There's the run for the stolen base, and he will get in there safe. Here's the throw to home, and in safe on a double steal. The count. Quick throw to second in safe. Holiday with 17.1 innings pitch. He's 1-1 on the season, 14 strikeouts. He's got a 4.84 ERA. That's going to be hit.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Now batting
number 20.
Now batting 14. Playing first base.
That'll be hit foul. Foul ball brought to you by Alex Dawson Photography. Two balls and a strike. That's going to be hit to short. And they'll get the shirt out at first, two away. And another run will score.
No. He wasn't ready. He wasn't ready.
Reagan Pierce. That's going to be foul tip, strike one. Here comes the 0-1. That's going to be low, ball one. Two away, one and one the count. Nobody on base here for the Trojans. And that's going to miss outside, 2-1. Two balls and a strike. And that's going to be a swing and a miss. 2-2, he tried to pull that back, couldn't do it. And that's going to be hit strong out to center field. It'll drop for a base hit. Johnson will get the ball back into the infield. So a single for Reagan Price, Reagan Pierce.
Now batting, number 9, playing left field, Joshua Liu.
Joshua Liu comes to the plate. Quick throw to first, and they kind of collide, but no harm, no foul. He's in there safe. And that's in there for a strike. 0-1 the count. Two away, runner at first. And that'll be a pass ball, and the Pierce will get to second base on the pass ball. Now runner at second base. That's going to be fouled out of play here in the bottom of the third. Foul ball brought to you by Lifelong Insurance. I also want to mention Holiday Realtors, Ebby Holiday Realtors, and LD Automotive. Thank you for being sponsors of Lobos Baseball.
Sponsored by Alex Stassen Photography.
Here's the pitch. High. 2-2 the count. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, runner at second. Here's the 2-2 from Halliday. Outside, full count. And that's going to be slap hit out of center. Johnson underneath it. And we'll get out of the inning. Not before. The score increases to 5-1 as we head to the bottom of the third. Keep it here. You're listening and watching Lobos Baseball on TSRN Sports and Little Elm TV.
I'm in 12th grade. I am our P&B chair as well as our Wolfpack president. My favorite class is definitely firefighting. Oh, that's a hard one. I want to say bacon cheeseburgers. Love me some bacon. Horror, for sure. Journey. Hold on, hold on. Oh, I wanna let go. That's a heart throb right there.
Dylan Terry, Frainer Chavez, and Kendall Johnson are the batters coming up here for the Lobos. Want to know the count to Terry? That's going to be low, 2-0. One on first base here for the Lobos. Chavez comes to the plate. That's going to be high and outside, ball one. Quick throw to first and safe. Outside corner, strike. One and one, the count. And he's going to bunt that nicely down the third base line. Everybody is safe, and a fantastic bunt job by Frainer Chavez. going to bring up the left-hander, Kendall Johnson.
Now, by number seven, center fielder, Kendall Johnson.
And that's going to be high. And a double steal is pulled off as they were looking for the bunt from Johnson. So runners at second and third now with no outs for Johnson. And he's up on the count 0-1. Want to know the count? John Mateer on deck. And he called timeout called at the plate. Outside, 3-1 the count. Dylan Terry at third, Frainer Chavez at second. No outs, and hit high to center field. That'll be a tag up coming. And he dropped, losing it in the sun, and it drops for a single. And Dylan Terry will score. Kendall Johnson will get a double out of it. John Mateer. And here comes the coach four, and that'll be all for Will Martin. They'll bring in number 10 on their roster. We'll step away as he gets warmed up. Keep it here. We'll be right back. John Mateer, and looks like Josh Montgomery on deck. He'll come in for Luis Cruz. Mateer showing bunt with runners at second and third, no outs. He'll pull that back outside, ball one. Thank you. fouled away. 1-1 the count. That foul ball brought to you by Lifelong Insurance. Also mentioned Evie Holiday Realtors and LD Automotive. Thank you for being sponsors of Lobos Baseball. And that's in there for strike two. Here comes the 1-2. And that's going to be tipped away. Stays alive, Mateer. Number 10 is Samuel Jenkins, the pitcher for the Trojans now. Two and two the count. We're going to go a little silent here for a little bit. We're having some issues with the microphones, getting them fixed up. And there's a hit, and it will drop foul just down the first baseline. Two and two the count. Swing and a miss, strike three. And that's a missed ball. And Mateer's going to try to run it out the first. And a bad throw. He will be safe at first. And a run will score. So Mateer will be at first base on a bad throw. He struck out, but because it wasn't a caught ball, he was free to run to first. Catcher couldn't find it, picks it up, makes a bad throw to first, so Mateer's safe at first. Runner at third and first. No outs. And another run scored by the Lobos. Cuts the lead from 5-3. Josh Montgomery in for Luis Cruz. And he'll try to bunt this and fouls it back. 1-1 the count. Sponsored by Girls Extreme Body Shaving. Quick throw to first. Mateer's in there safe. Josh again tries to bunt that one down, fouled back. 1-2 the count. Good strong hit. And that's going to fall for a base hit. And another runner score. Mateer will take it all the way to third in safe. Keeps runners at the corners. No out still. And now the Lobos are within 1-5. Here comes Brandon Dickinson. And he'll try to bunt this one back, fouls it back. Go, And that's going to be hit high. Far back, but it looks like it's going to get too high. And up underneath the center fielder, and a tag up by Mateer, and he will score. And we've got a tie ball game. One away as Dickinson will fly out to center field, call it a sacrifice fly. As Mateer will score, Montgomery remains on first base. One away, and at the plate is Paxton Marcon. And golfs this one too short, and they'll get the double play here. And that'll end the inning, but not before the Lobos. It tie this ball game up. We are all 9-5 as we head to the top of the fourth. Keep it here. We'll be right back here on TSRN Sports and the Little Elm Lobos TV.
I'm Brooke Russell. I'm in 12th grade and I play volleyball. My favorite class is probably my history class. My favorite food is corn dogs. My favorite Disney movie is Tinkerbell. My favorite sports team is University of Texas. It would probably be my great-grandma.
All right, welcome back. Swing and a miss, strike one. That's going to be in there for strike two. One ball, two strikes here in the top of the fourth. That's going to be high, two and two. That's going to be inside, misses. Three and two. There's the full count pitch. And that's going to be outside for a walk.
Well, what's he doing for the old door?
Now batting number one, the center fielder, Ryan O'Shea.
Ryan O'Shea comes to the plate. Oh, Nearly get him on a pickoff at first. Stolen base. One and oh the count. Here in the top of the fourth inning, all knotted at five. Low 2-0. Here's the 2-0 pitch. And fouled off.
That foul ball is sponsored by Billy Joe.
Two and one the count. And he'll try to punt this one, and that's going to be fouled back 2-2. Misses outside. Three balls, two strikes. Runner at second base. And misses on the inside and walks. Runners at first and second. No outs. And here comes Mark Smith. As he'll come out to have a talk, and we got somebody warming up in the bullpen there. That's going to be all for James Holliday. And it looks like John Mateer is going to come in to pitch. And number 16 Sam Mangan will head to left field.
We got some defensive changes for the Little Long Lobos. Now playing left field, Sam Mangan. And pitching for your Little Long Lobos, number 5, John Mutz here.
Kinds of changes going on. We'll step away real quick. Keep it here. We'll be right back here on TSN Sports and Little Elm TV.
Yeah. And you say Shy City. Shy City. Shy City.
I'm coming home again. Do you think about me now and then?
Yeah.
Do you think about me now and then? 'Cause I'm coming home again.
Oh.
Home again.
I met this girl when I was 3 years old. And what I loved most, she had so much soul. She said, excuse me, little homie, I know you don't know me, but my name is Wendy and I like to... And from that point, I never blow her off.
8, 29, 30...
All right, John Mateer on the mound. Mateer, 12 innings pitch. He's 1-0 on the season, 11 strikeouts. He's got a 7 ERA. And quick throw to third. And he's in there safe and a double steal. As runners advance from first.
Now batting number 5, the third baseman, Ian Collier.
Wait, he's talking to kids. He's talking to kids. Hold on. Erin Sharp, and I'm here with Coach Harbin. How are you doing on this fine afternoon?
I'm doing pretty good. You know, we came back and closed the gap a little bit and tied it up. Now we got to just chase one right now, so I'm doing pretty good.
Coach, you guys had an offensive breakthrough this last time up. How did that happen?
Well, we just started having a better approach with our bats, and then we kind of put the ball on the ground, did some fundamental things with bunting and getting guys over, and so that's usually what happens when we do that. So we usually start scoring some runs.
And what are you seeing from your pitching and defense today?
Defense doing pretty good. You know, pitching, we started a young guy in Roman and did some freshmen, and so we knew we were going to get there a little bit, and so we were going to coach him through it, and then James did okay, and then we decided to go with John. John did really good getting us out of that jam.
And then you guys had an injury scare pretty early on. Is everything okay?
Yeah, he's all right. He's been kind of dealing with a hammy, and it looked like he blew a tire right there. But I think he'll be okay.
All right, thank you so much, and thank you guys for these shirts.
Absolutely,
they look great.
Like them.
Thank you. Good.
And hit strong to short, and that'll get through for a base hit. Get things started here for the Lobos. They're down 6-5.
Now by number 21, the third baseman, Roman Robinson.
And they'll bring in a pinch runner for Irvin Leonard.
Pinch running for Irvin Leonard, number 13, Jake Johns.
Jake Johns will come in as the pinch runner. Looking to bunt, and they'll miss strike one. Punts this down third baseline. He'll pick it up, make the throw to first, and gets the one out, but he'll advance the runner to second base into scoring position with one away. Six to five is our score.
Second baseman, Dylan Terry.
Dylan Terry hits this one in the field, third base, and makes the out at first. But the runner will advance again to third base. That's going to bring up Freiner Chavez.
The runner on third, they'll bring up the shortstop, number two, Freiner Chavez.
Chavez. Singled and scored in the first, singled and scored in the third. Hats in there for a first pitch strike. Inside, ball one. And he'll tip that one off. One and two, the count. Again, fouls that off, stays alive. One ball, two strikes. Two away here in the bottom of the fourth. Lobos down 6-5 with the runner at third base. Chavez 2-for-2 on the day. Looking to make it 3-for-3. And tie up this ball game. Swing and a miss, strike three. And we are out of the inning. 6-5 here. You go ahead to the top of the fifth. Keep it here. We'll be right back here on TSRN Sports and Little Elm TV.
Little Elm
Minds
David like to remind you.
Brayden, I wish I could go to the game Friday, but the tickets are all sold out.
Man, have you tried watching a live stream on LE TV?
No.
Yeah, the only way to get closer is getting tackled by Jax Brown himself.
Why would I want to do that?
Better run.
Subscribe to LE TV.
Ben Francis comes to the plate. He's 2-for-2 on the day. John Mateer on the mound. And that's going to miss. 1-0 the count. High 2-0. Here comes the 2-0 from Mateer. And that's going to get in there for strike one. And that'll be hit foul. Evens the count at 2-2. And that'll be 3-2 outside. Full count to the batter, Ben Francis. John Mateer on the mound in relief. Here's the pitch. And that's going to miss. It looked like he got it to drop in, but a walk for Ben Francis.
Now batting number 23, the catcher, A.J. Gulaguri.
A.J. Gulaguri. Left-hander comes in with a runner at first base. No outs. Outside corner for strike one for Mateer. That'll miss outside, 1-1. And a hit and run on, and that's going to be a hit foul down the third baseline. Foul ball sponsored by Billy Go. Also want to mention John Lobb Toyota, Lifelong Insurance, Farrell's Extreme Body Shaping, The Outpost, and Mike Guerra with Keller Williams Realty. Thank you for being sponsors of Lobos Baseball. Fouled. One ball, two strikes.
Dunking.
Six to five is our score if you're just joining us. Here in the top of the fifth, no outs. Runner at first base for the Trinity Christian Trojans. And fouled that one out of play. Count remains one ball, two strikes.
No!
And that'll be a dribbler down the third base line. It'll remain fair, and they're not going to get him. That'll be a single.
Now batting number 17, the first baseman, William Lehman.
No outs, runners at first and second here for the Trojans. And William Lehman comes to the plate. Single that was stranded in the first and grounded out to short in the third. As he comes up for his third at bat. And he'll hit this one foul and out of play.
That foul ball was sponsored by Billy Go.
What he said. They'll bunt that one down third baseline. It'll go foul. Oh, and two to count. Time call by the batter at the plate. 6-5 is our score here in the top of the fifth inning. 0-2 the count to the batter. Runners at first and second, no outs. And that's going to be fouled away down the first baseline. Let's give a quick shout out to our Little Elm TV crew. You can go to YouTube and follow them on Instagram as well. Follow them on YouTube at Little Elm TV. The producer is Andrea Salamanca, the director, Julianne Oka. Camera operators being Erin Sharp, who's also the sideline reporter, did that great interview there with Coach Harbin. Travis Orr, Fernanda Huerta, Brianna Ciofani, Josh Paul, and Marin Scott. All right here from Little Elm High School. Congratulations on the work you guys are doing. It's fantastic, getting a lot of great compliments. Still 0-2 on the count to the batter, number 17, William Lehman. John Mateer on the mound in relief. And a fake pickoff move to second base brings the runner back. Hit the Chavez at short to second for the double play, and they get it. Runner advances to third base. Now two away.
Now by number 11, hitting DH, Reagan Pierce.
Reagan Pierce comes to the plate. One for two, fly out in a single. Swing and a miss, strike one. Here comes the 0-1, and a fake pickoff move to third. Gets Francis struggling. High 1-1. That's going to be a pass ball, and the runner from third will score 7-5. Two balls and a strike. Two away, nobody on. Swing and a miss, strike two. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, strike three, drops it. We'll make the throw to first for the out. And they're out of the inning, but not before giving up a run. As we head to the bottom of the fifth, keep it here. We'll be right back here on TSRN Sports and Little Elm TV. Oh, yeah!
You know, to be honest, I don't really like LED TV. Wait, what are you doing? Wait, no, stop. Where am I? What happened? What's going on?
Take it back.
What? No.
Take it back and subscribe to LED TV.
Or what?
Or you eat banana.
But I like banana.
Then we'll try something else then.
What are you doing? Come on, no, what? What? No! 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 This can't happen to me!
This is
no!
What
no!
When you don't
no! Stop it! Stop it! No!
Kendall Johnson, John Mateer, and Josh Montgomery. Lobos are down 7-5. Outside, ball one. That's going to miss outside, 2-0. Johnson, 1-for-2. That's going to get in there for a strike, 2-1. That's going to be high, 3 balls and a strike. And hits that strong to second base. Makes the scoop, makes the throw. And that's going to be a bad throw. And they're going to say they got him on the turn as Johnson turned into the infield, which you can't do that. Tried to scramble back to the base, and they've still managed to get him.
Pitcher John Mutt here.
And Coach Harbin's going to have a talk with the infield umpire on that one.
Please, social distance and wear face covering when in the stadium, but on the voice.
Please adhere to closed row signs on the designated green dots when choosing a seat. Thank you for helping us stay safe and responsible.
And now the umpires will come together. They'll discuss this to find out if they'll overturn this call as Coach Harbin pleads his case. And they're going to say he's out. So one away. That's going to bring up John Mateer. And he'll hit this one to first base. A dribbler, and they'll toss it to the pitcher. Two away.
Number 8,
the TA's Josh Montgomery. Now Josh Montgomery trying to get something going here. Single and was thrown out at second. And that's going to be in there for strike one. Low, ball one. 1-1 the count. Two away. Nobody on base here for the Lobos here in the bottom of the fifth. 7-5 is our score. Trojans with the lead. Swing and a miss. Strike two. That's going to be a ball. Skipped off the front of the turf before reaching the base. Evens the count at 2-2. And hits that strong right to the pitcher. And he'll make the easy toss to first. 1-2-3. As a gust picks up here at the backyard, we head to the top of the sixth. Keep it here. You're watching Little Elm Lobos Baseball right here on Little Elm TV and TSRN Sports. We'll be back.
What are you watching?
Watching sports on LE TV.
That's awesome. They have softball?
What? You don't even have a softball team?
Our softball team's better than our baseball team.
Stop the cap. No, you aren't.
Yes, we are.
Prove it.
I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Anything you can say, I can say faster.
I can say anything faster.
I'm gonna let you have that one.
I can say anything faster than you.
We can.
Yes, I can.
Take it.
Yes, I can. Take it.
Anything you can sing, I can sing.
Subscribe to LE TV to watch baseball and softball games.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
So a new batter in for Joshua Liu, number 9. They bring in number 7. Fouls that one off.
That foul ball was sponsored by LaMarche Family Landscaping.
LaMarche Family Landscaping sponsoring that foul ball. I just want to mention D3 Salon of Washington Washateria, Cheddar Scratch Kitchen, Huffine's Auto Group, Lifelong Insurance, and Farrell's Extreme Body Shaping. Thank you for being sponsors of Lobos Baseball. Swing and a miss, strike two. That's just going to miss. Ball one. Outside, even the count of 2-2. That's going to be popped up here near the first base bench, and it'll get out of play. Count remains 2-2. Swing and a miss, strike three. Make the throw to first.
Now batting for 14, second baseman Charlie Frankie.
That's going to ring up the short second baseman Charlie Frankie. 0-2 with a walk. One away. Want to know the count. Swing and a foul back at the screen. 1-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. One ball, two strikes is the count. One away, nobody on. Mateer catches the outside corner, strike three.
All right, all right, all right. Now batting number one, the center fielder, Ryan O'Shea.
Ryan O'Shea comes to the plate. He's over three, but two walks. That's going to miss the outside, 1-0. Outside corner for strike one. One ball, one strike to the batter. Nobody on, two outs. There's the pitch. Low, 2-1. Outside, three balls and a strike. Fouls that one off. Full count coming up, three balls, two strikes. Two away, full count. Here's the payoff pitch. Outside, walks him, ball four. Yeah.
Now batting number two, the shortstop, Steven Ramos.
Steven Ramos, the left-hander, comes up. 1-for-3 here on the day. Doubled and scored in the first inning. Grounded out in the second and fourth. Quick pickoff play to first. He's in safe. High, ball one. And that's going to just miss on the outside, 2-0. Runner first base, two outs. Trojans lead 7-5. That's going to get the outside corner. Two balls and a strike. Safe at first. Two and one the count. That's going to be low and outside, 3-1. That's going to get in there, strike two. Full count. Three balls, two strikes, two away, runner at first. John Mateer on the mound. Here's the pitch, and fouled out of play. Ramos stays alive at 3-2. And that'll be a walk. Runners on first and second, the two outs.
Now that's going to bring up Ian Collier. Playing third base, Ian Collier.
That's in there for a first pitch strike. Low, 1-1. Fakes the pickoff, move to second base. Count remains 1-1. Two outs, runners are first and second. Ian Collier at the plate. Outside, going for third, and it's a high throw, and he will score. Eight to five is our score. Two balls and a strike. That's going to get the inside for strike two. Two balls, two strikes. Runner at second base. Swing and a miss, strike three, gets out of the inning. Not before another run is scored. 8-5 is our score. Keep it here. We'll be right back.
That's strike three.
Brandon Dickinson, Paxton Markheim, Irving Leonard are your batters here for the Lobos. And it hit the third base by Dickinson. Long throw. Gets him. One away. Foster Wiley comes into the game batting for Paxton Markheim. Outside, strike one. That's in there for strike two. Low, ball one. One ball, two strikes. One away, nobody on here for the Lobos. Foster Wiley at the plate. Here's the pitch. That's going to miss inside, 2-2. Swing and a miss, strike three.
Now by the first baseman, number 24, Irvin Leonard.
Irvin Leonard comes to the plate. That's in for a first pitch strike. Bottom of the sixth inning brought to you by The Outpost, Mike Garrett with Keller Williams Realty and McKee Law Firm. And that foul ball brought to you by McKee Law Firm. 0-2 the count. High ball one. And hit strongly up the middle, and that'll get through for a base hit. So a runner at first base with two outs for the Lobos.
Now batting the third baseman, number 21, Roman Robinson.
When the police hit the lights, I do not.
Roman Robinson comes to the plate. Outside, ball one. Robinson started off the game on the mound. Stayed in the games, moved over to the third base. And now hits this one well up the middle, and that's going to drop for a base hit. Back-to-back singles here for the Lobos. Runners at first and second, two outs. Dylan Terry.
Now batting number 20 is second baseman Dylan Terry.
Dylan Terry comes to the plate as he represents the tying run. Quick throw to second, he's in safe. Lobos playing hard. Looking to get caught back up in this game. And that's in there for a strike. 0-1 the count. Frainer Chavez is on deck. And hits this one to second base. And they will take the sure out at second. And they're out of the inning. Score remains 8-5, but a good inning that time by the Lobos. We head to the top of the seventh. Keep it here. We'll be back.
What's wrong?
I failed my test. I could not focus.
Here, try this.
What's this?
It's Propel. Trust me, it'll work.
See so. Oh, wow, like, that's actually pretty good.
He'll pass in no time.
Thanks to Propel, you'll pass all your tests. Get it today at the Deca store and the cafeteria.
John Mateer remains on the mound here as we head to the top of the seventh inning. Number 21 comes to the bat, Ben Francis. He is 2 for 3 with a walk, 2 singles. Here's the pitch from Majeer, and that's going to miss inside, ball one. Hat gets the inside corner, strike one, 1-1 the count. Low, 2-1. That's going to hit the outside corner for strike two. Two and two the count. Here comes the 2-2 pitch from Mateer. And that's going to miss low. Full count, 3-2. Fouls this one off and out of play down the first baseline. That foul ball brought to you by McKee Law Firm. Also want to mention John Lob Toyo, RS3 Turf, and Lazy Dog Restaurants. The Outpost and Mike Guerra with Keller Williams Realty. Thank you for being sponsors of Lobos Baseball. Gets the inside corner, strike three.
Catcher, A.J. Guliguri.
A.J. Guliguri. 2 for 3. Ground out, 2 singles. Also scored a run in the first inning. That's going to be hit to first base. And they're going to call that a fair ball and out.
Now,
all right, first base, William Lehman. 2 away. William Lehman at the plate. 1 for 3 with a single, and swing and a miss on that one, strike one. And he's going to foul that one off, 0-2. Swing and a miss, strike three.
3-3 down for John Mateer. We head to the bottom of the seventh inning.
So the Lobos come up here, bottom of the seventh. They're down to their last three outs. They're down 8-5. Keep it here. We'll be back here on TSRN Sports and Little Elm TV.
What? Over? Did you say over? Nothing is over until we decide it is.
Let's do it.
Let's do it! Go, go, go!
Go!
Over? Did you say over? Nothing is over until...
Frainer, Chavez, Kendall Johnson, and John Mateer, your leadoff hitters to start things from the top of the order. Here in the bottom of the seventh inning, they're down 8-5. Looking for something to go in here. Chavez fouls one off 0-1.
How about well, sponsored by Mackie Luffer.
Oh and one, and that's going to get the outside corner 0-2. Chavez didn't like that call. He steps away, takes a moment, comes back, digs in. Here's the pitch. Fouls away, stays alive at 0-2. Outside, 1-2. One ball, two strikes to Frainer Chavez. No outs, nobody on. Here in the bottom of the seventh, they're down 8-5. Here's the 1-2, and pops it up. And the pitcher will call it waiver. No, third baseman will come in and wave him off and makes the out. 1 away, and Kendall Johnson.
Hello, fans. I can't hear you. Let's hear some more for Kendall Johnson.
Shows bunt, pulls it back, ball one. Swing and a miss, strike one. Freshman Kendall Johnson. 1-for-3 today. And he'll hit this one, pops it up. Third baseman makes the out, 2 away. Lobos down to their last out. John Mateer comes to the plate.
Lobos, this is our last shot. Let's get it loud. Leoff, number 5, John Mateer.
Josh Montgomery on deck, and that's going to get in there for strike one. Here's the 0-1. Mateer hits this one, golfs it. It drops to second base, makes the throw, and that's the end of the game.
That concludes the ball game today. Final line score for the visiting TCA Trojans. Had 8 runs on 8 hits.
Final score for your Lobos.
They had 5 runs on 6 hits, 2 errors. We hope you had a fun time here at Ballpark. And please drive home safe.
8-5 as the Trojans get the win. Join us on Tuesday, 7:30 first pitch, 7:15 airtime for a pregame as we will go to Rockwall. Then we're back home on Saturday. That's right, you heard me right. We've got a game on Tuesday night, and then Saturday, a Saturday game against Rockwall on the rubber match right here on TSRN Sports. Little Elm TV, thank you for joining us here. As we're going to call it a day, get on out of here on a Saturday afternoon. You guys have a safe and wonderful weekend. Thank you for joining us here on Little Elm TV and TSRN Sports.